Testing. Testing 1, 2, 3. We should be live. Hello, everybody. Hopefully you could hear me. Hopefully I got the levels right. Hopefully nothing is on mute. I hope. How is everyone doing this evening? It's 1 minute to midnight. July 28th, 2023. I think I just solved the echo problem. Tell me if it went away. Yep. Have to wait 30 seconds for everyone to confirm that the echo went away. The time delay. We're operating in different time space. Low volume and lots of echo doesn't sound good. Still? Testing 1, 2, 3. Is there still echo? Shouldn't be. I wish I could hear what you're hearing. Still echo. Beam me up. Still echo. Okay, how about now? Testing 1, 2, 3. The echo pedal must be on. Still, yes, still. Sounds horrible. Wow. Testing. What is going on? How about now? It's a midnight timestamp. Is there still an echo? Tim Thomas said sounds good. Rob Baker says good. So has the echo been resolved? Perfect. Better. Good. So no more echo. Perfect. All right. Always something. How is everyone doing this evening? I am going to get started with one of those bad boys right there. Today, we're going to do two things. I'm going to break this show up into two segments. It's not going to be a Tone Vault series video. We're going to mix it up a little bit. Metalhead Hippie in the house said, I'm good. If Metalhead Hippie said, I'm good, I am good. Gone. Audio's perfect. Excellent. Thank you. So, the agenda for this evening is as follows. I haven't really covered other gear, like new gear, we're in August this year, I don't think. If I did, it's very little. So one company reached out. I think they have really interesting and cool stuff that's incredibly useful. So I agreed to cover it, and I hope you dig it. And then the second half, I have been dying to do a pickup swap, and I figured, you know what, let's do it live. It could be fun. We could chat. I could work, and we could make an evening of it. And I'm going to show you a tip on how you can swap a pickup solderless, so maybe you'll want to hang out and watch that. So, and I change it pretty quick in a way that you're probably going to say, why? And the short answer is because it's easy. Makes pickup swap super easy. With that said, I'm going to say hello to everyone. Let's see who was first in the chat this evening, according to YouTube. Dusty Wilson in the house, followed up by LaRue918, Sasso, Tim Thomas, AQ Music in the house, Herb of Fireside Studio, Gary Davlin, dude, what's up? Dusty, Tim, Grandpa Joe in the house, FYL Fox, Guitar Man 45, one of those. Guitar Man 45 is a subscriber to the channel, and I thank you for that. And stay tuned, because I'm going to be sending out a YouTuber subscriber thing for next weekend. So just keep a lookout for that, as well as my Patreons in the house. So expect something coming across in the next few days as well. Sasso P, Natasha in the house, Metalhead Hippie, of course. Okay, I'm going to scroll to the bottom. If I missed you, a group, bad boy right there for everyone in the house. So, and by the way, I think everyone knows the drill. If you have any questions, you're welcome to ask. I typically, unless I catch something and want to address it, I typically don't scroll up. So just keep asking until I answer. And, And that's the plan for this evening. Rob Baker says, I did a pickup swap today, but it was definitely soldered. Put a SD Seymour Duncan Invader in one of my old Strats single humbucker setup. Yeah, you know, I would say in general, soldering is good. you know, it's a nice stable connection. My use case is a little different. I have one guitar that I just test pickups in. So I have a terminal block, which, by the way, there's a link in the description if you want to see the terminal block that I actually use. And it just makes it really easy. And I have a whole setup station back over there. So it makes it really easy. I could pretty much do anything to a guitar except finish it. You know, it gets involved. So for pickups, which are a little bit of a PITA, I use a terminal block. And again, I'm going to share that with you. Link is in the description if you want to see what that looks like. But I'll show you. Okay, I'm going to keep my eye on the chat. So if anyone has any questions about anything, you are welcome to ask. And Music Therapy Laz, I was just watching one of your videos with your bird going into your glass of water, which I thought was cute as anything. And I say that because my son has a bird. And my God, if you're not familiar with birds, they have their own personality, like a dog or a cat. It's pretty fascinating. So I have a whole new love and appreciation for birds. Music Therapy Laz, I was watching your bird video earlier, which I think was on Facebook, if I remember correctly. Who else do we have? Dwight Bailey, Ike Stoddard, Hip Metalworks, Rico B. They're so social. They are. And it's interesting because my son's bird, my wife usually takes him out of the cage, or my son, but my son works a lot. So my wife will take the bird out of the cage and he hangs out. And as soon as I walk into like whatever room, he comes running to me. And then he wants to bite me. So I think it's a love-hate relationship. I think he loves to see me, or either that or he's telling me to, you know, get out of there. I don't know. Grumpy Mike Guitar. You know, dude, I was actually thinking of you with what I'm going to cover tonight, because I know you make videos and all that stuff. Metalhead Hippie, you as well. I think anyone that, you know what? What I'm going to show you, I think if you make music, I think this might be helpful. And so anyway, let's jump into that. So a company reached out to me called D&A, not DNA, but D ampersand A. And let me share my screen. So I'm going to do this. And I'm going to put my face right there. And they reached out to me and said, hey, we have some cool stuff. And my first impression was like, no, thank you. And then I looked at it. I always look at everything. In fact, I've turned a lot of things down this year, like a lot of pedal stuff, just stuff that I'm tired of doing. But this one caught my attention for a few reasons. Number one, and I have them here. I'm going to show you everything. We're going to do a show and tell. The stand is incredibly stable. Okay. So most stands usually have like one or two legs. Most of the time, just one. This one has five, which is just kind of insane. Incredibly well built. They have three different kinds. The Starfish, which is a five-legged stand, the Starfish Plus. The Starfish, which is a four-legged stand, and the Hydra, which is a six-legged stand that holds three guitars. They have a really unique cradle system. So this is the Hydra. And again, I have everything here. It's $119. I put the link in the description. It is not an affiliate link. So if you buy something or you don't, I don't make a dime from this and they're not paying me. They did send me the stands, but no money has been transferred. And I don't get any commissions at all. So just to be clear, this isn't a sales pitch. This is, if you dig it, great. If you don't, that's fine too. And that's my full transparency statement right there. So this Hydra multi-stand is in the price point of other like stands, except other like stands don't have as many legs. It's incredibly stable. And again, I have it here. I'm going to show that to you. So that's the Hydra. The Starfish Plus is a single stand with also five. And I think of things like this. If you're at a gig, if you're doing the whatever it is, open mic night, your guitar is not coming off of this stand. Plus, it has this cradle here. It's a little blurry. But this cradle that locks in. So not only is the... How do I get out of this? Not only is the stand... Can I scroll? Oh, there you go. So not only is the stand incredibly stable, but your guitar is literally locked in. Not with those two little things, but it actually completely seals it. Okay? I'm going to give you a live demonstration of that. I thought that was very clever, both from a stability as well as the thing is not coming off the stand no matter what you do. And then, before everybody gets sticker shock, let me explain. They have this Bullhead Extreme Ultimate setup. I know everyone's going to say, $373, that's a lot of money. But let me explain to you what's going on here, okay? And like I said, I have no one, I don't get a commission if I sell it. They're not paying me to say this. This is my own independent, honest opinion on this. In fact, I'm going to do something real quick. I'm going to give you perspective. I brought this to show you something. When I do my outdoor videos, this is actually a name brand. It's made by Vanguard. And this is what's called a multi-mount. Now, this has two extra mounts. It only comes with one and two. It's actually a little crooked, but two camera mounts. I added two extra mounts, okay? And then this thing goes on your tripod. This is not light, and it's very wobbly on a tripod, okay? The reason why I bought this is so I can do, let's say, a GoPro, maybe away from me, a GoPro on me, a light on me, a microphone. I wanted to put a lot of things on here, and I think I used it once because it is too heavy. It could hold the gear, but too wobbly since it's a single point. That's all that's holding this whole thing up on a tripod. Okay. Great idea, but it's just too top heavy for the gear. I bought this, I think, way back when. Maybe I spent $200 just on this because I needed something. I didn't want to walk out with five tripods. I wanted something like that. So, why did I show that to you? Because this here basically does that and more. So this thing has a guitar stand down here with a guitar rest. You could put your picks. It has six of those camera mounts. So you could mount a microphone, a GoPro, an iPad, a light, two boom stands. So you could mic an amp. You could have a mic for your vocals, a camera, an iPad. It has everything, and it's incredibly well made. Okay. In fact, here's the Vanguard thing I showed you. Mine had two extra, and you can't even get this anymore. And I looked, I couldn't find anything else that allows you to mount more than one camera, maybe two cameras with like a V mount. So somebody that is busking outside on the go, even in a tight studio space, you have one stand, incredibly sturdy stand, that does all of the above. And it comes with everything. So you could see it's got the hub, which is basically the stand, dual trio plates. I'm going to show you what that is in a second. Dual boom arms, the tablet holder, six adapters, and cable clips. And here's some pictures of what the, what do they call this? A trio plate. Okay, and like I said, I'm going to show you everything. So a little pricey, but given what it is, if you have a lot of things you need, yeah, it's a portable rig, okay? So I wanted to share that with you, and now let me show it to you. So I'm going to come back over here, and let me get this out of the way. Let's start with the tri-stand over here. So I do have a camera set up on this. Let me do this. Bear with me. Okay, so this here, it's not the best shot, but I'll take the guitars off and I'll show you everything. This here, can you see that? Yeah, so as I pick this up, that unlocks. And then I could pull the guitar out. If I put the, and basically what's happening here is, as this goes down, that locks. Okay, so you put your guitar in there, it goes down, it locks. So there's really no way to get the guitar out. Okay, this one here holds three guitars. I'm gonna take these off the stand for a second. And I'll show you the stand up close and personal. Don't fall. So, let me come back over here. Okay, so, I don't want to hit things. So basically, let's see if you could see everything here. I'm going to go to this camera. I get a little bit more real estate on this camera here. And I keep hitting, I'm going to drop the stand for a second. This way it's not so tall. Oh, it's also adjustable. So you have, how far could I go up? So you have these six things at the bottom, which again is incredibly sturdy. Okay. You have these, which are metal. These are metal, a plastic end, but metal, I don't know what you call them. Things that you lean your guitar into, okay? And you could spin this, or you could lock it down. I like spinning it because you could keep it, you know, every guitar is a little different, so you could leave it a little loose to adjust it. You saw that it's adjustable, and here are the head pieces. So if I go like that, it locks. So, an incredibly sturdy stand. It's mostly metal, rubber, and some plastic. So, metal legs, metal vertical bar. Even this piece is all metal right there. So, the actual three-way is metal. In fact, and it's incredibly easy to set up. I'll show you what this looks like. So when you get it, this is off. Can you see what I'm doing? Yeah. So that's all metal. And again, when this goes down, it locks. So I thought it was a very clever design, and this also locks in here, so you can't spin it. And then this is just a screw that holds it all in place. And it just clamps it down. And you're good to go. So that's the three-way right over here. Really nice stand. Let me put that back over here. We have the same thing in a single stand. It's a little different in that, can you see everything? There's a lever here. So the lever is what determines if it goes up or down. Same locking mechanism here. So that locks the guitar into place. And this is five here. Let me see if you could see that. So again, incredibly sturdy. And you don't, this one is nice. You don't have to screw anything. Pick that up and it slides right up. So it gets real portable, just like that. Okay, and that's your single stand. So I'm gonna put that back out, lock it, bring that up, lock it. I'm gonna put that over here. Now, let me read the comments real quick. John Gregory says they really did their research and development. I thought so also. And that's why I wanted to cover it, because it's a really good stand. Michael D says, is it nitro friendly? I knew that question was going to come up, so I prepared for the answer. The answer is probably not, okay? But this is what I do. And I put a link in the description. I bought like 24 of these. They are basically 12 inch by 12 inch black towels. Okay? It's got a little cat hair in here, but you get the idea. And I put this on every, if a guitar touches rubber, even if it's polyurethane or polyester, especially nitro, I put one of these between the guitar and anything the guitar is touching. They're 12 inches, so you could fold it in half and you get 6 inches, which goes across a, you know, a guitar cradle. In fact, I could show you on that. And I put this for the neck and the body, and they're not that expensive. And with something like this, I don't have a problem at all. It's basically a washcloth. I like that it's black, because even if you have a case, and I think everyone knows I'm incredibly finicky with cases, if there's not enough neck support, I fold that, put it right under the neck. If the body's a little loose, I fold that and wrap it around the bottom end of the body. So I put this link in the description. I must have 2 dozen of these at least, because I use it for guitar cases, I use it for guitar stands. It's black and it blends in with everything. So I kind of one of these, I don't leave home without these. And again, that link is in the description. They're not microfiber. They're just like a soft terry cloth. And microfiber, while they're good to clean, microfiber could also leave very light surface scratches if it's the wrong microfiber. This, it's nothing. It's incredibly soft cotton. I think it's cotton. Let me see. 100% cotton. Premium quality, long staple, 100% cotton. And that's what I use. There you go. That's what I use, again, in guitar cases, on guitar stands. As Michael D said, it makes it nitro friendly. 99-cent store. We have a Dollar Tree by us, which is actually fun to go to because they have like insane amount of stuff. But I like black because it blends with everything. You don't see it on the guitar stand because the guitar stand's black. You don't see it in the guitar case because the guitar case is usually black. And I'm finicky with stuff like that. So I bought these. And again, link is in the description if you want a black towel that just works with everything and will protect your finish. I actually did a video a while back on how a Fender case that had a little rubber grommet at the bottom ruined the finish on a Fender guitar. Guess what's at the bottom of that case now? One of those. So don't take your chances. Put a cloth between your guitar and anything that even looks like rubber, okay? Especially if you don't know what the finish is. Grumpy Mike says, did you hit that like button? Thank you, Grumpy Mike. I appreciate that. So with that said, let's take a look at the Bullhead Extreme. So, it's a little big, so I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. I'm going to take this guitar off real quick. I'm going to go to my overhead camera, where's my overhead camera? It's over here. And let me do this. Oh, okay. It's here. So, of course, it's the thing is on the wrong side. Okay, bear with me. There we go. Okay. So, this here, I'm going to move it in a little bit so you could see it like that. So I have the iPad holder up here, okay? You could clamp it down a little more or a little less if you want. I'll move that over, center that. You could spin it around if you want. So you could put the iPad however you want. There's two boom arms on here. So if you wanted to have like a microphone facing you and maybe something facing an amp on this side, you could do that. There is a cradle over here. Can you see that? You can't see that. Let me move that back a little bit. Can you see that now? A little more. There you go. So the guitar will rest here. You could throw some guitar picks in there. I don't have any here at the moment. But just to be illustrative, you could throw like your guitar picks or whatever you have, your wallet, doesn't make a difference. It's actually a nice size. And then you could take your guitar and it leans just like that. This one doesn't have the locking mechanism like these over here. So you definitely want to be careful, but it's still a really good stand and you have everything going on with that stand right there. Now, I have some, let me come back over here. Okay, I have some of the pieces here. So this is the piece, the main piece, okay? And if you notice this, everything is real simple. So this just slides off. It actually pushes down. In fact, if you look at the mechanism, it locks it in this groove right here, okay? And these, look at the wheel on here. That's really nice, very friendly. You could put anything on here and get your fingers in here and spin that dial. And it comes with six of these. One, two, three, and then four, five, six, which are on there. And these just pop off and they snap into place. And even these are very heavy duty. They're metal. And again, a really nice, sturdy locking wrong way. Nice, sturdy locking mechanism. Okay. And the bottom, where's the bottom? Just clips on from here. So no tools, and you get six. And again, where's that piece? When you think about this monstrosity that I wound up buying for good money and I never used it, look how streamlined that is. Neat and clean. Okay. Just to show you a picture. And it comes with these microphone clips, which I didn't hook up because I didn't hook up microphone cables. Okay. That's really it. I'm going to share one more time. That's the Bullhead Extreme. Again, you get two of these things, whatever they're called. What are they called again? The trio plates. Each trio plate holds six of the camera mounts. It comes with two boom arms, and it comes with the guitar stand and the pick holder, as well as the iPad holder. So really just very slick. I think, I know it's a lot of money, but I think you get what you pay for here. The Starfish Plus, again, it has that locking mechanism, and this five-legged stand make it twice as stable as the competition. Its extra 2 points of contact allow up to 33 degrees of tilt. I don't know why you'd want to tilt your guitar that much, but yeah, see? your guitar won't tip over and it locks in at the top, and then you have the three stand. And I think they're priced right. $120 for that, $60 for this. I think it's a pretty good deal for what it is. Good enough that I wanted to share that with you. So that is all I'm going to share. That's the new product update. What are your thoughts? Do you think it's was worth sharing with you? Michael D says no tools means less screwing around. Yeah, I put all that together. I took it out of the box, and I think it was the Hydra tool is the only thing that I screwed the top in. Everything else popped open with a quick release lever. No tools at all for any of it, which was really nice. But the Bullhead Extreme, that's what I was most excited about, because I've done a lot of, you know, you go to the NAMM show, I go outside and do some videos or whatever. It's just nice to be able to have one thing. You could have cameras in both directions, microphones in both directions, and extra camera mounts on a stable stand. Sign me up. Grumpy Mike says, if I bought all that, what do I do with all this duct tape? That's a great question. It's a good question. I was excited about that. I think it's good quality. If it wasn't, I wouldn't have done the video. But I did want to share that with you. And it's funny, I've been talking to them for a few months now. And I'm not that quick with emails. Every time I get an email, I get back to someone a week later, and then they get back to me a week later. Next thing you know, it's like a month or two, you know. Dan Avenger says, it says it's safe for all finishes. Dan Avenger, I personally wouldn't take a chance. I'd still put a towel. Let's put it like this. Nitro guitars, chances are you spent good money on that guitar. I would put something between the guitar and the stand, even if the stand says it's safe. I've been burned. You know, Fender case, Fender guitar, and it literally burned the finish. What's the expression? Fool me once, shame on me. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Something like that. Less stuff you have to take to the gig. Yeah, I mean, one tripod gives you one camera mount. When I used to do my video at Chuck Levin's, I had at least three tripods with me, and it still wasn't enough. I had a light, I had a GoPro, I had my, this has everything. I would just throw this in the trunk. I could put everything on this thing, you know. I wish I had this when I did all the on-site stuff. Even if you don't put a guitar in there, it's nice for all the camera mounts and everything else. But listen, we talk about guitars, we play guitars. The fact that it has a guitar stand built in is a beautiful thing. One stand, six camera mounts, a guitar stand, mic booms. You know, what more do you want? So I thought it was good. Buy twice, cry nice. So anyway. Great Vanzini says, looks good, especially compared to the normal junk you see in stores. And let me tell you, there's a lot of normal junk out there. I remember a long time ago, I think it was Musician's Friend, at one of those like holiday or deal of the day, it was the guitar stands were like $8 each, something like that. I think it was just shy of $10 each, and I bought like 10 of them. I can't use them. They're garbage. I bought them, and it was so cheap, it was like I wasn't going to return them. But it was garbage, just garbage. You know, you learn that, again, you get what you pay for. You get a cheap stand, don't cry when your guitar hits the floor, right? Ian says, I remember that show, very disappointed with the name brand. Yeah, it happens, unfortunately. All right, so with that said, I am going to put these stands over there, wheel over something, and we're going to do a pickup swap. Does that sound like a plan? Everyone good with that plan? So I'm going to do this. We're going to take a quick intermission, and I'm going to set up for the pickup swap. So I'll be right back. Okay. So, I set up for a pickup swap. Okay, so what I have going on over here is I have a pick guard, and what happens here, actually, let me come back over here real quick. Soldered onto the guitar, the back of those terminals, and that's my hot and my ground. So I'm going to take off of one, and I'm basically going to screw it in that terminal. And it's all pre-wired and ready to go. And these are prototypes, Badland pickups. So I have these prototypes, and I actually use a Strat to test it because it's so easy to swap out the pick guards. But it's real interesting in what I do, actually take the neck off. Because it's quick and it's easy, and that's going to be the plan. So I'm going to come back over here, and let's get started with this. So basically, I'm going to capo the. Let me move the mic over a little bit. I wish I could see you. I guess I could see you okay. So I capo off the neck, and going to pop the neck off. Want to make sure that's in view. And now I have a guitar that is ready to be worked on. Let me check the comments. So there's not a lot of, they're locking tuners, so there's a hair on it, and it seems to work out okay. Again, I'm kind of quick in, and this is, you know, I've done this many, many times, so it's, so far it's worked out well. So let's pop this off. Nope. My bit is too big, so I'm going to use this. need a small screwdriver. That's it. One pick guard out. And we're going to pop the new one in. Let me do this real quick. I'm going to come back over here. I wonder if I could get you more angle like that. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Pickup swap is complete. Power tool, I do. I didn't want to be rude and excuse myself to go get a smaller bit. I already excused myself once. Okay, I'm going to put this back together. Let's do this real quick. Yeah, I'm going to go get a smaller bit so you all don't have to watch me screw in how many of these 13 holes. I'll be right back. Okay. I'm going to come back over here. And Capo keeps the strings in the good call. Ian says, Badlands pickup loaded pickguard. Yes. That's why I didn't want to show the covers, because these are not on something we're releasing yet. I'm going to turn some amps on, and let's hear how it sounds. Okay. So, almost redneck style. Quick and easy. That's the goal. And I don't care about this guitar. It's just something for me to test pickups. Okay, I'm going to kill the vocal mic and let's... I was looking at the wrong place. Let's check it out. That better. The levels, I had to bring the levels up a little bit. Sounds like a smooth chainsaw. Okay, let's go back. I'm gonna kill the vocal mic. So I got to tell you, I like that a lot. It's so what did everybody think of my down and dirty? What did I change that in 20 minutes? Easy breezy. So we have one guy, really spectacular guy, and all he does is build pickups for Badlands. That's it. That's all he does. So we spend a lot of R&D, research and development, in really trying to nail very particular tones. And that was the latest round. So I think it might not be a secret. We're announcing our new launch. Stay tuned. Sign up on the website for the newsletter if you want to get notified. But coming real soon. And those pickups won't be in there, but that's probably going to be the next run. But I like that. That sounds really good. And it's definitely 80s-esque, so it's not like over-the-top, like ridiculous gain. It just sounds clear, articulate, a little bit raspy. Think JCM 800, like kind of that sound. Not too much, not too little. In fact, we are introducing a new pickup in the next line, the next run we're doing. And I can't wait to tell you about it because there's so many really exciting things about it. And one of those is a new pickup that we're introducing. And I love it. Love, love, love it. And when you see it, you'll be surprised that I'm saying that. But I'll explain everything in due time. Sometimes I just can't help myself. Ralph Higgs said, great jobs. Yeah, about that long. DNA did their R&D for those stands. You know, the R&D, interestingly enough, is the fun part. It's, you know, let me put it to you like this. Having a conversation with someone smarter than you, because the guy who builds the pickups is definitely smarter than I am. Being able to explain a sound and a tone, and we're real particular, by the way, right? I'm leaving the particulars out, but it's got to sound like this. And having someone translate that with wires and bobbins and magnets is pretty impressive to me. Just someone that has, it's like no different than someone that could build an amplifier that has the ability to kind of take what's in your head and put wires and resistors and capacitors and all that stuff together to create that is an art to it. You know, I always talk about guitars are art. Research and development and having someone that really understands the ins and the outs to take what's in your head and make it a reality is an art. And, you know, is it a hot pickup? You know, I have the spec on it, not in front of me. But it's 80s hot, you know. Dusty said, sounds great. Is it going to be a different Badlands guitar? Well, it's going to be the same body shape with lots of new stuff going on. Really exciting stuff. Our goal is to create these limited runs and just outdo ourselves over and over again. So the next will be better than the next, will be better than the next, and so on. At least that's our goal. You know, is to just, you know, create amazing instruments that hopefully people that buy them love them, you know. Ike said, well, I will ask in an email. What question did you have for me? I probably missed it. But yeah, if anybody wants to send an email, you're welcome to. info@thetoneking.com. I am a little slow in emails, so bear with me. But yeah, if you want to send an email, that's fine also. And those are ceramic. Those are 80 ceramic. I wish I could tell you more. But you got to hear something for the first time. Same time I got to hear it. I've had that for a little while, and I've been wanting to put it in. and I'm glad I just got to do that. These are passive. I think I shared something with you all the last time. Oh, I don't have it here. We are working on something active. I think I might have shown on one of my last shows a prototype that we had. And I think the spec is good. Let me go get it. Hang on. I'll share something with you. Bear with me. So just to share with you a little behind the scenes here, let me see what I can share with you here. So basically, this is one of our prototypes for our active electronics, and that should look a little familiar to you, maybe, but lots of real interesting. So we're not messing around. I mean, we did the circuit board from start to finish. We have a designer, and in due time you'll know who that is. And just really spectacular work. And it's not going to be like a EMG active pickup. That's not what we're going for. We're going for something a little different, incredibly useful. And when you, and that's not going to be this next run. It's probably going to be the next one, the third run. We've been at this for a while. We've been at this for, I want to say, 4 months now. We've been working on this, many different prototypes. But when it's done and we explain to you what it does, everyone will be like, ah, why didn't somebody else think of that, right? Usable. Everything we do is really the guitarist in mind, like what does a guitarist want? What will make it sound better? What will make it sound great? But yeah, I mean, when you look at the handiwork on that, it's pretty impressive. You know, it's pretty impressive what smart people can do. You know, being just a gearhead and loving tone and chasing that tone and having an opportunity to work with people that know how to translate that and build something is the best part of Badlands, is being able to actually build something that, again, hopefully the people that buy it really dig it, you know. With that said, we learned a lot on the first run, you know, a couple of hiccups here and there. For those that got the guitars, you know, logos could have been better on the case, the boxes could have been better, the shipping times could have been better, the ETAs could have been better. We learned a lot. We took it all on the chin, and we're really looking forward to just doing it better and better each time we come out with a new one. That's the goal. We listen to every customer, you know, feedback. We've encouraged the feedback. Tell us how you really feel, type of thing. And just one at a time. Talk about the now. I'm right in the middle of a pickup swap to PF Joe Mojo into a Made in Korea JS100. Nice. Sounds like a nice set. My favorite. Oh, I have some good news for you. So I've been actually talking to the good folks at DiMarzio. I think everyone knows the Super Distortion and the PAF Pro is my favorite. And so I'm going to be covering some DiMarzio stuff, which I'm really excited about. And I have the capability. I'll use this guitar, right? Just pop it off and install the new ones. And but for my TTK2, I think everyone knows the BC Rich Mockingbird TTK1. Has a Super Distortion in the bridge and a PAF in the neck. So I'm getting a red, same thing, Super Distortion PAF Pro for the TTK2 in red with black slugs. It's gonna look awesome. So I'm gonna do that for a live show too, probably. I'm really excited about that. Something I've wanted to do for a while. When opportunity knocks, open the door. Go for it if the chance avails. Yeah, that's what we're doing. That is what we are doing. Martin Hensley says, Badlands needs to hook up with Agree pickups. They have a part active, part passive. It sounds better than EMGs. I never heard of Agree. But I have to look them up. Martin, I'm forgetful. If you want to send me an email with Agree pickups, I'd love to check them out. And, you know, it's interesting. When we launched, we had a lot of companies, even the big boys, reach out and say, hey, we'll do pickups for you, right? And the pickups for us was something we really wanted to do in-house. Again, we have a talented individual that's just been knocking it out of the park. And we want to stick with that. You know, it's kind of got to play the TTK through the Jakey Lee. I got it back there. You could see it. Oh, the other way. But yeah, the pickups are something we, and it's interesting. We could actually put like Dunkin's as an example for less than it's costing us to make our own. But we're proud of what we're making, really proud of what we're making. So, you know, it costs more, but that's okay because it's, you know, it's ours. That's not to say, I mean, listen, we've had endless amounts of conversations. Someday we might throw DiMarzio's in there. We love DiMarzio. Someday we might throw Dunkin's in there. We love Dunkin's. But right now, kind of the first few launches, we really want to, you know, let the world know what we're capable of doing. Kind of get our brand out there and our thoughts and our designs and all that. That's, you know, that's part of the passion. That's part of the dream, is to make it our own. And so far, so good, I think. Oh, Martin says they're in England. Yeah, send me. I'm always up for learning about something new. Even if it doesn't go into Badlands, maybe it goes in something else. I'm always down for cool gear, you know. Anyway, my fellow rockers, hopefully you enjoyed the show. A little bit different. I needed a break from the Tone Vault stuff. I wanted to show you the stuff back there. I think it's DNA, I think is really good stuff. You know, hopefully you enjoyed it. And hopefully you got to see my fast and dirty pickup swap. And I have about a dozen of those pick guards pre-wired. So I swap them in and out. Takes me, by the way, did anyone time me? How long did that take from start to finish? 15 minutes maybe? So it's a good way to do it. You know, I know it's probably not good for the guitar and blah, 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 but changing pickups is tedious, right? I don't want to get into the whole restring it, you know, it's just like, so I picked the guitar, I picked the Strat because the pick guard is easy. Even DiMarzio, they make preloaded pick guards, right? So you could load anything in a pick guard and pop the neck off. That's it. Anyway, do I have a Bugera XXX? I do not. I sold all my Bugera amps with the exception of the 1960. I have two of them, the original and the Infinium. Interestingly enough, it's not the best sounding amp they have, but one is the original that's been modified to the Randy Rhodes spec. There's actually a backstory. When I had an amp tech, he's the late Dennis Kager, and he had the schematic to the Randy Rhodes Marshall, the limited edition Randy Rhodes. He modded my Bugera stock 1960 to the Randy Rhodes mod. At the time, I was working with Bugera and Uli Behringer, actually, I was talking to directly, and I shared with him what we did to my Bugera. So the Infinium is actually what my stock was spec'd at. So I have both. I have the Infinium and the stock. So there's a little backstory to that. And that's why those were the only ones I kept. But when I was moving from my old place to this place, I had too much stuff. And the Bugeras, you know, they were affordable, good amps. But like I kept the Marshalls, I let the Bugeras go, that type of thing. Let a lot of stuff go just to make the move a little easier. Anyway, my fellow rockers, thank you so much. I hope you had a good time tonight. I always have a good time hanging out with you. If you want to give me a thumbs up on the way out, I would appreciate it. Jimmy says, do you have more amps than what we see behind you? I know you state you have more guitars than what we see. Sorry for the personal question. I do. In fact, if you go back to, I know I did a studio tour maybe a year ago or so, and you could see a bunch of stuff. Also, check my Instagram. I have stuff on Instagram, so you could see what I have lurking around here. Hopefully that answers your question. David Sanchez, buenos nachos con queso, amigo. You know, that joke still, it's still in the household. I kiss my kids goodnight. Buenos nachos con queso. And they say it back to me. So, it doesn't get old. Michael D., thank you. Ike Stoddard, thank you. Jimmy Ray, Luis Villarreal, Delta Tech, you'll see me again. I'm glad I caught the show. Awesome. Ike, Jimmy Ray, and for everybody that tuned in this evening, really appreciate you all being here. I know you could be doing anything else, but you came to hang out and talk about gear, see some cool stuff, and, you know, see me tear a Strat apart to load up a pick guard. Ron, Ian. Oh, Ian likes the shorts. Thank you. I'm trying to mix it up a little bit. I'm trying to mix it up. You know, YouTube doesn't make it easy, because I've been doing a lot of live shows, and now they, like, live shows don't appear as videos. And I had two people so far say, you haven't uploaded a video in a long time. I'm like, every Friday. They're like, but when I click on videos, I don't see them. I'm like, oh, God. Like, YouTube just keeps taking it apart. So actually, I may, for fun, I'm going to take the 1 hour live shows and make like a 10-minute clip and upload that as a video. So if you miss a live show and just want the highlights, I'm going to be uploading those. So the video tab will be the short version. The live tab will be the long version. And the shorts, I just have fun with the shorts. And if you read between the lines on the shorts, I'm picking very specific things that I find interesting. Check it out and leave a comment and see if you're picking up what I'm putting down in some of the shorts. You'll get it. They're not all like that. Some are just funny. But pay attention to the interview ones. And leave a comment and let me know if you got it. Anyway, my fellow rockers, one of those, the great Vanzini, I don't know if I said hello to you. Grumpy Mike, dude, thank you for tuning in. Janice, Kubrick, Jimmy Ray, Matt, Ike, and company, in case I missed you. Group Ad Boy, thank you so much. Have a great weekend. Go sign up for notifications on BadlandsGuitarCompany.com. You'll thank me later, because we're going to have some real exciting news coming out real soon. And we're excited and hope you are also. Metalhead Hippie. All right, folks. Have a rockin' weekend. Be safe, have fun, play your guitar. See you later.